Welcome to the world of coding. Today in this video, I will be introducing you to GitHub Copilot, the ultimate tool that you need for streamlining your coding workflow. Whether you are a seasoned developer or just starting out, GitHub Copilot is a perfect companion for your coding journey. Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri. I'm dedicated to bringing you the latest news, insights, tips on cloud technologies, web framework, APIs. Today, I'll show you many ways where GitHub Copilot can help you to write better code. So sit back, relax, and let's dive into the world of GitHub Copilot together. To start your GitHub Copilot journey, you need to go to this URL called github.com/features/copilot. And then start your free trial. It's very easy. You come to this page, click on this start your free trial, and then give all the details, and then it will tell you that your free trial is ready. Your free trial will expire in 60 days. After that, you need to pay $10 per month to with this GitHub Copilot. So in this video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you multiple ways how GitHub Copilot can be used to make you a better developer. And then you decide whether you want to continue with this tool or not, because it's a tool for which you need to pay $10 per month after 60 days of trial period. So once you are done with all the login processes and everything, you need to go and install this Copilot on the Visual Studio Code. So let's now go into the Visual Studio Code. So here I am in my Visual Studio Code. The first thing that you need to do, you need to go to this section and search for Copilot. And you will find the first option called GitHub Copilot. Come here and install. Since I've already installed that, so that's why it's showing me uninstall, but the first time it will show you a install option, and you go ahead and install that. Once it's installed, you will find this Copilot logo at the very bottom right corner of your screen. So once you install Copilot, let's see how it can help you to make a better developer. So for that, let's create a file called helloworld.js. Now let's say I want to create an array of months. So let's put a comment, create an array of months. Now let's start writing const months. You can see it already started giving me the option, because it's intelligent enough that it read the comment and understand what is the intention. So the moment I start writing months, it's already giving me the construct of the array. What I can do, if I'm okay with that, I can just press on the tab and it will give me this entire array. It is also intelligent. Let's say I don't want the full month. Rather, for January, I want the first three characters like Jan. For February, only Feb. So once I start writing this way, look, what it is doing is that the moment I wrote the first one, which is Jan, it understood that, okay, for the rest of the month, I don't want the full name of the month. I only want the first three characters. So it already started giving me the option that this should be the way how you define your array. And I can click on tab, and that's all I need to do. So this is one way how you can easily create an array, and GitHub Copilot will help you to construct the array. Okay, let's see the next one. Let's say I have a function, and in that function, I'm returning an object. So let's write the return statement. Here, let's say name is something which is coming from student.getName. Age. Now the moment I put age, you see the prediction, it's already telling that it should come from student.getAge, and I can do a tab, it will auto complete the option. Similarly, if I put address, it's telling that it's coming from student.getAddress, because in this case what I'm trying to do, literally I'm trying to return an object, and in that object I'm using some function from the student to get the name, age, and address. But the beauty is that the moment I wrote the first line, which is name colon student dot get name, GitHub Copilot is intelligent enough that it knows rest of the input like age and address should also come from student. Okay, let's see the next one. Let's say I want to filter out something. I want to filter only the big opportunities. So only big opportunities. It started giving me the option. Let's say I have a list of opportunities dot filter, and it's already give me the option that, okay, if the opportunity amount is greater than 100K, then only consider those opportunities as your big opportunities. Let's say I'm trying to add countries to the opportunities. Let's see if Copilot can help me write my code. So it's asking function, which is add country to opportunity. And here is a list of opportunities I have. Now, the moment I hit enter, it actually gave me a code which I can review and if it is really what I'm trying to do. Now, if I don't like this option, I have this next, previous and accept. I can click on next, which will give me the next prediction. Or I can click on this open GitHub Copilot, which will open the Copilot in this another window. And here it will show me all the solutions. For example, this is one solution. This is another solution. It will give me all the solutions for my problem. So if I think this is a solution that I'm looking for, I can just click on that and I can click on this accept solution and the code will come here. So this is a way how Copilot can help me write my code. Copilot is intelligent enough to understand from the name of the function, what is the intention of this function, and then autocomplete the code or write the code for me. Similarly, let's write another function. Let's say max between two numbers. Look, the moment I write the name of the function, Copilot understands that this function needs two input, A and B, and then it will return the max between A and B. And it's already gave me the code. I can just click on tab and my function is ready. Let's play a little bit. Let's make a bubble sort. Let's make a function called bubble sort the array. And the array came. It already gave me the entire code to bubble sort an array. And I can click on tab. My code is ready. So how do I know that this function is really working? The only way to know that by writing some test classes. So let's put a comment, write test code for bubble sort array. Now let's put a describe and it started giving me all the options and my code is ready. So here, if you see that I first wrote the function and then I took the help of Copilot to write a test class for the above function. So here, what we understand is that Copilot is not only understand your instruction, but Copilot also understand the context of the instruction. So when I'm telling that you write a test class for this function, it means Copilot is intelligent enough to find out that, okay, there is a function already available. So why don't I go ahead and create a test class only for this? And this is really impressive. Okay, so let's take it to the next level. So if you like test-driven development, where you write your test class first and then you write the implementation to make your test pass, right? So let's see if Copilot can help us follow the test-driven development approach. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a test file first. Let me give the name of the test file is student.test, right? Now, can Copilot be intelligent enough to read the test class and write the actual implementation for this test class so that this test methods will pass? Let's create a new file called student.js. Let's start typing the class. But look at the beauty. Copilot already read my test functions and gave me the construct of this class. What I can do in this stage, I can just hit the tab and accept this change. And now all these test methods will pass because my student class is ready. Even Copilot is intelligent enough that in this situation, what I'm trying to do, I'm calling a function called double age, which is changing the student age from 20 to 40. And here is the function. And what's basically doing, changing the age line by 2. So it's really impressive, right? It not only gives us the option to write our code in a much better way, but at the same time, you have the option to see what are the different possible solutions for a single problem. For one problem, there can be multiple solutions. It doesn't always necessary that whatever solution that you are writing is always the best solution. There can be other solutions. So there is no harm to check out the other solutions and find out what is the best one, and then according to you, use that in your implementation. So Copilot is definitely going to help you in that way. And in the long run, it will help you to write better code. So that's all. Let me know what is your feedback. Put your feedback in the comment section of this video. And thank you for joining me on this journey of discovering GitHub Copilot. I hope you have learned about this powerful feature it offers and how it can help you to streamline your coding workflow. Whether you are working on a personal project or a team project, this tool is a perfect tool to manage your code. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get updates about all my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.